Wow, I started using some of the different progress monitoring measures. Now I need to focus my attention on the instruction within DBI. Where do I find information about evidence-based interventions to address all the different needs of my students?
Well, that's a great question, Mr. Flores, and that's what we're going to work on in this module. Here's where we are. We have talked about developing a scope and sequence for instruction, and then we talked about progress monitoring to determine students' response to that instruction. And so now we land here, and we're going to think about evidence-based practices that can be used to inform the instructional platform. So our objectives for this module are the following. In part one, we're going to talk about what are the different forms of evidence-based practices that we might want to use within intensive intervention. In part two, we're going to talk about, well, where do you locate evidence-based practices? And in part three, we'll then figure out, well, how do we take those evidence-based practices and make an instructional platform for a student? So the activities that you will do in this module include the following. In part one, you're going to look at different types of evidence-based practices, and then you'll rate evidence for evidence-based practices. And then we want you to share an example of an evidence-based intervention or strategy that you find useful in your classroom. In part two, you'll do two different activities. Well, you'll look at websites that rate evidence-based practices, and then you'll look at different mathematics interventions and figure out what the evidence is that supports those interventions. And then in part three, you'll do two activities thinking about a scope and sequence for a student based on using evidence-based practices. You'll look at different evidence-based interventions and strategies available at your grade level. And then finally, you're going to have a discussion board activity where you describe the evidence-based practices that you're going to require within intensive intervention. In this module, you do have a reading. It's called Taking the Guesswork Out of Locating Evidence-Based Practices for Diverse Learners. Seems pretty appropriate to read for this module. And in this article, they talk about this framework for evidence-based practices. And we'll talk about this in a lot more detail. But here we have our umbrella term of evidence-based practices. And within that, then your first choice should be evidence-based interventions. Your second choice should be evidence-based strategies. When neither of those are available, then you should look at promising practices. And finally, we always want you to remember that you shouldn't take practices that don't have an evidence base and use those within intensive intervention, because that wastes students' time. So by the end of this module, you're going to evaluate a current instructional intervention or strategy and figure out what is the evidence that supports the use of that intervention or strategy. So we're so glad you're here. Welcome to Module 3. Let's go ahead and get started.